Before returning to Euclidean domains, I want to say a little more in general about GCDs. So first, I want to point out that we defined GCDs in terms of common divisors of two elements A and B. And then we said what this means in terms of the ideal generated by A and B. And proposition 2 of section 8.1 on page 274, just to help orient you to where we are in Dummit and Foote, just restates this discussion as a proposition. And what have we seen? If A and B are non-zero elements in a commutative ring R, and the ideal generated by A and B is equal to the principal ideal generated by D, then D is a common divisor of A and B. So if this ideal generated by A and B is a principal ideal, then it's clear that there is a unique smallest principal ideal generating, containing the ideal generated by A and B. What is it? It is the principal ideal, which is the one generated by A and B, and a GCD is any generator for it. Okay, so this is a useful thing to keep in mind, that in the case where the ideal generated by A and B is principal, we know that we have a nice GCD, just take a generator for that principal ideal. Okay, so in this discussion of GCDs so far, I've been trying to remember to say a greatest common divisor instead of the greatest common divisor, because there isn't uniqueness in this definition. But the next proposition says how all these different greatest common divisors are related to each other. So let's say that R is now just an integral domain. If you have two elements, D and D prime and R, and they generate the same principal ideal, so the ideal generated by D and the ideal generated by D prime are equal, then how are those two elements related? D prime is equal to U times D for some unit U in R. So in particular, if these two elements are both greatest common divisors for A and B, that is, they are both generators for the unique smallest principal ideal containing A and B, then how are they related? D prime is equal to a unit times D for some unit U in R. All right, so let's prove that this is true. And if either of D or D prime is zero, then, okay, so what is this principal ideal that they generate? Well, one of them is the principal ideal generated by zero, which is just zero. So the other one is also generating the ideal zero. So the other one is zero too. So this whole statement is clear and not so interesting. So now let's suppose that D and D prime are both non-zero elements of R, and they generate the same principal ideal. Well, now, since D is in the ideal generated by D prime, that means that there exists an X in R such that D is equal to X times D prime. That's what it means to be in the principal ideal generated by an element in a commutative ring. So the other way, since D prime is in the ideal generated by D, that means that there exists a Y in R such that D prime is equal to Y times D. And now the idea is just replace this D prime here with Y times D. And what does that say? That means D is equal to X times Y times D, right? What's the point of this? We want to say that D prime is equal to a unit times D. And we know that D prime is equal to Y times D. So we want Y to be a unit. Okay, so D equals XYD. So let's take a subtract and get that D minus XYD, which is by the distributive law, D times 1 minus XY equals 0. And D is not zero, and we're in an integral domain, so D is not a zero divisor. So D times something equals zero means that something must be zero. So 1 minus xy is equal to zero. Or add xy to both sides, xy is equal to 1. And we're in a commutative ring, so xy equals yx equals 1. That means that both x and y are units in this ring. So that proves the first part, that D prime is equal to U times D for some unit U in the ring. Okay, so for the second part, what does this mean in terms of GCDs? Well, if D and D prime are both GCDs of A and B, then by the interpretation of what it means to be a GCD in terms of ideals containing each other, that means that the ideal generated by D is contained in the ideal generated by D prime. But on the other hand, the ideal generated by D prime is contained in the ideal generated by D. So these two ideals are equal. And now we can just apply the first part, because we're in an integral domain and we have two elements that generate the same principal ideal. So D prime is equal to U times D for some unit U in the ring. Okay, so now that we have like a slightly better general understanding of how GCDs work, we're gonna go back and see how in the case where our ring is a Euclidean domain, and we have this division algorithm and can apply it repeatedly, this gives us an algorithmic way to compute GCDs.